Hello dear road trip lovers, and welcome to a new road tourings video. We are on the motorway A2 in Slovenia on the bypass of Ljubljana, and we are leaving the motorway now to travel today on a very nice national road, the G106. We will explore today a very nice corner of the country while driving from Ljubljana to Kocevje. Like I said, on the national road G106, means in Slovenian, I think, Glavna Cesta. It's national road. This road will take us through a very nice hilly landscape in a region that is not very well known for tourists, but is very, very nice. And you can discover here some traditional Slovenian villages and small towns. The region's historical name is Dolenjska, or Lower Carniola in English. Lower Carniola is being delimited to the northwest by Ljubljana Basin, to the south and southeast by the Croatian border with the Gorjanci Mountains, and by the Sava rivers to the north, and by Mount Krim and Bloki Plateau and Potok Plateau to the west. These plateaus separate the Lower Carniola from Inner Carniola. And now, before we are too far from it, let's say a few words about the capital city of Ljubljana. So Ljubljana is the capital of Slovenia. It has a population of almost 300,000 inhabitants, being the biggest settlement in the country. It lies in the Ljubljana Basin, between the Alps and the Karst region, Karst plateaus, at an elevation of about 300 meters, a little bit south of the Sava River. Ljubljana has a very long history, being first mentioned in the 12th century. It was a historical capital of Carniola, a province of the Austrian Empire, until its dissolution after the First World War in 1918. When it became part of Yugoslavia, or Kingdom of Serbs, Slovenes and Croats, I think it was called back then. And it was the capital, it became the capital of independent Slovenia after 1991, when the country proclaimed its independence from Yugoslavia. The city is very, very nice to visit, as most of the historical center was well preserved. The city's architecture is also a mix of styles, as a downtown got its shape in the Middle Ages, and after an earthquake at the beginning of 16th century, parts of it were built in Baroque style following Italian influences, and after another earthquake from 1895, some other parts were rebuilt in Vienna Secession style. There is a pretty large pedestrianized area in the center with a lot of cafes and restaurants and very nice atmosphere. I liked it a lot when I visited the town about 3 years ago, I think it was. There is also a castle called Ljubljana Castle, situated on a hill over the city center. That's a medieval castle from 12th century, so dating from basically being exactly as old as the city itself. Nowadays there is a funicular that goes up, and there are many cultural events that take place up on the castle hill, the area being also very nice for taking walks, offering very nice view of the downtown Ljubljana and the area around. And now let's see also some nice pics from that I took in Ljubljana, in order to get a better glimpse of how nice the city is, because we are not driving through it, we are driving just through the suburbs before leaving the Ljubljana area. And after seeing the peaks, we'll drive further to Kocevje. Now I hope you like the pics from the capital city of Slovenia. And now let's hit the road further through Lower Carniola to our destination, the town of Kocevje. We are now driving through a few suburbs of Ljubljana, like Lavrica, Skofljica, or Pijava Gorica, I think it's pronounced. I'm not very good in Slavic words pronunciation. We will be at the beginning in a relatively flat area at altitudes of about 300 meters, but we'll soon leave the Ljubljana basin and climb to a nice plateau at altitudes of about 500 to 600 meters. And we'll drive through a very nice mix of forested and wide open areas with some small inhabited places now and there. The most important place on the way is the town of Ribnica. It's a small town with about 3,500 inhabitants. A very nice stop on the way with a historical core that worth a visit. The town is very old, dating back to 1920. So it's basically exactly 800 years old. It's actually one of the oldest towns in Slovenia. And now let's enjoy the nice drive with some music, and I'll be back towards the end of the video to tell you a few words about our destination, the town of Kocevje. Thank you.
Thank you. bird on a tree. I'm just sitting here. I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together, it's so beautiful. You and me, we meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free. Step back to see the truth around you. From a distance you can tell. Free.
again as we approach the town of Kocevje. I hope you liked the nice tour through Lower Carniola until here as much as I did while driving there. It was very, very nice. Kocevje is a regional center of the area with a population of about 8,500 inhabitants, located at an altitude of about 460 meters on the Rinza River at the foothills of Kocevski Rog Karst Plateau that you see on the right of us. The town is quite old, being first mentioned in the year 1363, and has a few older buildings in the town center to admire. The town is also a very good base for exploring the big forested area towards the Croatian border. And I will end the video as we enter the town and will feature the drive through it during the following videos that I am preparing now, when I drove further on to the Croatian border, over the Croatian border actually to Delnice. That was also a very spectacular drive. And I hope you liked the video. I hope you liked the nice tour through Lower Carniola. And if it's like this, I'll be very glad if you will like also the video on YouTube. And if you have any comments, suggestions, and or want to ask me some questions, please feel free to leave me a comment and I will try to answer as fast as possible. And if you generally like what I am doing and want to see more 4K road tourism videos, please subscribe to my channel and activate the bell in order to be notified when I am posting new videos from different regions. And with that being said, I'm finishing the video as we enter Kocevje, and I'm saying goodbye to you, and till the next time, bye bye.